Hi, boys and girls. Well, while we are still in the country of Greece, let's take a look and remember the celebration we learned about in the story before. We learned about how St. Basil's Day was on January the 1st and they had the Vesalopita cake. Well, another part of that celebration is to lay the feast out on the table and to bless the bread by making the sign of the cross over it and then lifting the table up and down 3 times to ensure that you have good luck for the rest of the year. I think that's pretty interesting. I'm going to try that the next time I have a feast. Make everyone stand up and lift the table up and down 3 times to make sure we have a good year. Well, we notice in looking at the map of Greece that is surrounded on 3 sides by seas. So we have 1, 2, and 3 sides surrounded by different kinds of seas and oceans. We also notice in looking at the map that there are hundreds and thousands of little tiny islands. Some of them are so small they do not even have a name on this map. In our story today, Mishi and Mashi, they're going to go touring around the country of Greece so we can see some of the things that we might have seen when we were in Greece. So let's take a look. Oh, before we do that, there's a picture I'd like to show you of something they do in Greece during the celebration time of year. And what they do is they decorate the fishing boats with lights that are blue and white to match the flag colors of their country, which I think is pretty neat to decorate the fishing boats since the oceans and seas are such a big part of their culture. What a great idea. So let's go with Mishi and Mashi to Greece. And I see that one of the girls is holding the Greek flag there, and we can see those blue and white colors to match the water and the white crests of the sea. And the story is written by Mary George, and it's illustrated by Lisa Saki. Mishi and Mashi's family are going on a trip to sunny Greece. They have packed a car with bathing suits, inflatable toys, a canoe, fishing rods, cameras, and everything else they need for a fun summer holiday. Looks like they're going to be able to drive to where they're going. Interesting. Mummy, where is this big boat taking us? Mashi is curious. Oh, this boat is called a ferry, and it's taking us to an island, a piece of land surrounded by sea. Greece has thousands of them, Mummy explains to the girls. Mummy's totally right. An island is a piece of land that is surrounded by water. And that's why it's called an island.
Mum, Dad, look at the dolphins. They're dancing.
The girls point at the water. They're welcoming us to Greece, Mummy says, enjoying the show. Oh, and we know that the dolphin is the national animal of Greece, probably because it is a sea-dwelling creature. What a great idea. The family arrive and are welcomed to a beautiful villa by their host. Calamera, I hope you like olives, the kind lady says cheerfully, pointing to the trees which surround the villa. These are olive trees.
Can we pick some right now?
The girls ask. The landlady laughs and explains that olives can't be picked and eaten directly. They need to be prepared first.
Wow, we learned about that in one of our other lessons where cooking or cooling food makes it into an edible product.
Once unpacked, they hurry to the beach. The girls play on the rocks all day while Daddy paddles with the canoe and Mummy drinks frappes, a typical cold coffee. It is such a fun day for everyone, but they're getting hungry.
They head to the Taverna, a local restaurant with delicious food. They eat sea bass, that's a fish, octopus, another animal that lives in the sea, shrimps, also lives in the sea, and even seashells. Sea is even in its name.
Did Daddy catch all of this seafood on his canoe today? The girls inquire.
Daddy just shrugs and Mummy winks.
I don't think he caught it. I think they just ordered it at the restaurant or taverna.
Over the week, the family explore Greece. Their first stop is Santorini, a beautiful island with white and blue houses and churches.
I've seen so many pictures with this view, Mishi says. Let's use our selfie sticks.
The girls take pictures and have lots of fun.
I wonder why these buildings are painted white and blue. Can you figure it out?
I agree with you, to match the colors of the flag and the oceans and seas that surround them. Then they drive to the beautiful monasteries in Metaurora that rest on the high mountain. Mummy begins to worry.
I hope we don't have to walk all the way to the top of the mountain.
When the road stops, and they do have to walk the rest of the way, Mummy pulls a face.
Welcome to Greece, says Dad.
There must be a lot of walking.
On the island of Zakynthos, the girls see a shipwreck and a whole family of tortoises resting in the sun. They want to pick them up and play, but a local boy appears.
Oh, we know about that. You can use your eyes to observe and see, but remember to leave nature be.
He explains that the tortoises can't be picked up because it's not allowed.
My name is Apostolos, he says with a friendly smile. I can show you how we have fun in Greece.
So there's the girls with the tortoises.
This is our traditional Zorba dance.
The girls watch as Apostolos takes them to where his friends are dancing.
This is my favorite instrument, the bouzouki. I'll play it for you.
Wow, he must be very talented to be able to play a musical instrument.
The music Apostolos plays is very lively.
This looks so much fun. Let's try it, Mishi.
And the girls join in the dance.
Now look at the Greek sky, and let me tell you a story. Over there in the mountains live the Greek gods and goddesses. Each one of them has a special power. Athena is the goddess of wisdom, and she can create crafts.
I like doing crafts.
Our capital, Athens, has been named after her.
Hey, we're going to Athens next, Mishi grins.
I hope we see Athena, says Mishi.
Girls, here we are at the splendid Acropolis in Athens, Daddy says as they arrive.
Is this the home of Athena?
Mashi is interested.
Yes, it was a long, long time ago, Daddy replies. I understood why she moved out. It's so old.
Mashi nods. They all laugh. The girls are ecstatic to find Athena's statue. So when we see an old, old building like this, we would call it an ancient ruin. Very interesting. And of course, that happened in the past, a long, long time ago.
On their last day, they visit the old Olympic Stadium in Athens.
Daddy, what are those Olympic Games? I thought adults are boring and don't play games.
Mashi is puzzled.
No, we're not so boring. The games include tennis and football, running and jumping, and many more sports. Every country in the world competes in them, Daddy explains. Greece was the first ever country to host an Olympic game.
So there's the rings of the Olympic symbol.
It has been a fun holiday, but it is time to go home. Mishi sighs and stamps her foot.
It's so sunny in Greece. I want to stay here forever, she cries.
Mum tries to cheer her up. The host lady says goodbye and gives them a pot of delicious olives for the journey.
And Theo, see you again soon.
So I'm glad that Mishi and Mashi got to go to Greece, and they noticed a lot of things and got to see a lot of places on their holiday.
Well, we did talk about how Greece has a lot of oceans and seas around it, and a lot of food came from the oceans and seas, which is why they needed so many fishing boats. I want you to think about foods that you eat that come from the ocean and are part of the ocean and sea life cycle.
I think one of the foods I eat would definitely be squid rings. I like eating squid rings or calamari. Some people like to eat crab. Other people like to eat lobsters. What is some food that you like that comes from the ocean or the sea?
Draw about it and write about it. Label them in your journal. Pick four.
I wonder what I'm going to pick.